Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome to episode 2 of the $500 account challenge. If you saw part 1, you know that I am currently running a small account growth challenge on the channel where I deposited $500 into a new Robinhood account, and I'm going to be looking to grow that as consistently as possible. The goal of the challenge isn't to make all this money with $500, but really just to help encourage other people who might think they need a ton of money to get started, and really just show you some of the ways that you can start investing with a smaller account. So in this video, I'll show you guys where the account is currently sitting, show you some of the open positions that I currently have, and then we'll jump into my screen and I'll break down and really just go through all of the trades that I took over the past 2 weeks and show you exactly why I decided to take them. And if you're not subscribed to the channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button and drop a like on this video if you like this concept and you want to see more videos like this. But anyways, let's get right into it. When I open the account, you guys can see the balance is $516.90, which was up 0.43% on the day, 1.65% on the week, and then on the month we had 3.38%. So pretty consistent gains. And then when I scroll down, I'll show you guys some of the positions that I currently have open. So I have Carnival, ECPG, and then LVS. And I'll hit on those in a little bit. But for now, I just want to go over the positions that I've closed and really just explain why I decided to take those trades. So now when I jump into my account history, you guys can see all the stocks that I have bought and sold since I deposited the initial $500. So I'll just go through all the positions that I closed and just show you how many shares I bought and at what price I bought and sold them. So the first one, January 5th, I bought one share of Chewy for $89.11. Then I sold that, looks like, but next day actually for a pretty good gain. I sold it for $95.94. And then let's see, the next one was Apple. I bought that for $127.77 and then sold it a couple days later for $131.95. Microsoft, same thing, bought that on the 6th, just one share at $214.43. Sold that on the 8th for $219.83. Then it looks like the next one that I closed out was Twitter. So I actually took a loss here. This one kind of just went against me, so I decided to cut it off pretty quick. But I bought two shares at $48.23, then sold it, cut my losses, looks like on the 15th, a couple days later, at $45.97. And then the next one I bought was Pfizer. I bought that for $106.81, sold it a couple days later for $109.35. And the last one is Spirit Airlines. So I bought three shares here at $25.76 and then sold them, it looks like 5 days later, at a average cost of $27.81. So a couple pretty good gains there. There's a rundown of all the positions that I've closed out. I also made a little spreadsheet just as it's probably easier to keep track of all the closed positions on there. As when I start trading more on here, it's just gonna be super clustered. And if I don't buy and sell them within a couple days, I'll just have to be swiping all over the place to find everything. So I'll show you guys that spreadsheet and just give you a better visual of how much I made percentage-wise or how much I lost. So we can take a look at that. So just to go down the line here, Chewy, we had a gain of 7.66%. Apple was 3.27%, Microsoft 2.52%, Pfizer 2.38%, and then Spirit was a pretty good one at 7.96%. And as I said, I had a little loss here on Twitter for 4.69%. Didn't really go as planned, but I'll explain more of that when we jump into my Thinkorswim platform. So I'll use that spreadsheet to help keep track of everything. It'll probably be easier to follow down the line. But now I'll show you guys exactly kind of my decision-making process and why I decided to buy and sell all those stocks at the point I did. So now we can jump into my Thinkorswim platform, which is just a TD Ameritrade's trading platform that I use for like technical analysis, charting, and stuff like that. So here is my Thinkorswim platform, and the stock we have up here right now is Chewy, which was the first trade that I took, and this is currently the 1 year chart. And I actually have an entire video just completely dedicated to Chewy, just explaining why I see a lot of value in this stock and company moving forward. But when it comes to this trade, I was really just looking for any form of pullback just to try to get some skin in the game. So I have these little arrows here where I bought and sold, but after this all-time high, we saw a pretty significant pullback of almost 18%. So I saw that to be a pretty good buying opportunity. I'll switch over to the 20-day just to kind of zoom it in a little more. So I bought right here around this level, and then I sold it, like I said, a couple days later up here. Missed out on a pretty good run up to a new all-time high. It was up like 20% after I sold it. But, you know, I made 8% on that trade, so I didn't want to get greedy, so I just decided to book the gain. Yeah, if you don't know what Chewy is, it is an online retailer for all things pet-related. They sell pet food, toys, supplements, all different types of medicine. And since the pandemic, this company has just absolutely exploded with the huge shift to online shopping. And this is something that, as I said in the video, that I definitely expect to continue. And I think this stock has a lot of room to run over the next year. So yeah, on this trade, I was really just looking for any kind of pullback and then look to see some consolidation just to show that it's not going to keep selling off and making lower lows. So I bought right at this point, sold it up here, and that's kind of just a quick recap on Chewy. So now we can go up to the next one, which was Apple. So this is the same thing, 20-day chart. And I'll explain this and Microsoft kind of just in the same clip here, because it really was the exact same trade for me. I don't know if you guys remember, but this is the time right when I bought it, right around here. This was the point where there was a ton of fear in the market and people were just completely panicking, because it was when all these protesters and people were just storming the Capitol. So I don't know if you guys were trading this day or just paying attention to the market, but right around like 2 o'clock, when all the news started to break that people were raiding and storming the Capitol or whatever, the market had a huge sell-off. And we had stocks like Apple and Microsoft, I think just on this day, you can kind of still see it here, but you know, they sold off like 3% intraday. So a huge sell-off that I saw as a buying opportunity. I didn't really think it was going to continue or hold. So I decided to buy just one share here. Same thing with Microsoft. You can see it's really just this exact same chart. But yeah, there's a pretty aggressive pullback, even from its 20-day high. It was, you know, off like 6%. But, you know, when the market started to sell off there, I just saw that as an opportunity. I didn't think that it was going to continue selling off just based off all the panic. I thought it was more of just a short-term thing. So I bought it there, and then a few days later, I ended up selling for a couple percent gain. And then this one kind of pulled back again and then had another rip just last week back up to all-time highs. But, you know, as I said before on the Chewy example, you know, never be afraid to just book gains, even if you wanted to just sell some. I only had one share, so I had to sell it all. But yeah, that was kind of my reasoning behind this entry point here. If we zoom out on the 1 year chart, you can see it's really just, it was making all-time highs back up to, it looks like, a couple months ago. But it's kind of just been trading within this tight range. So when it sold off to this point, kind of just a support level here, I decided to buy in. I would have held this one for a little bit longer, but a 2-3% move in just a day or two on Apple or Microsoft was a pretty good gain. So I decided to just book that and kind of just allocate that money somewhere else. So now we'll go in and we'll take a look at the Twitter. All right, so here's Twitter. And same thing, you can kind of see the arrows here where I decided to buy and then sell. This one went just over 4% against me in a couple days. So did not work out as planned. But my mindset with this one was kind of the same as Apple and Microsoft. It had a huge sell-off from just in a couple days, really, where it was off more than 10%. And a lot of this was due to same thing with all the Capitol protest and all the rumors that kind of came after that, how all these people were going to be banned from Twitter, like Trump was banned. And it was just like a huge ordeal where they were saying how the free speech or whatever was being suppressed. A lot of people were going to end up leaving the app. So I decided to kind of just go against that and buy into that, really just to look for like just a 1 or 2 day bounce after that aggressive sell-off. I didn't know if it was going to be a huge deal and if that was going to affect Twitter really for the long term. I thought it would kind of just be like a quicker sell-off and then a little recovery once people kind of stopped like panicking after a couple days. But that one didn't really work. So, you know, it kind of just broke down for a couple days after that. It's recently recovered back up to the level around where I bought it. But when something goes against me like that, and I wasn't really trading Twitter because I love the company or whatever, it was kind of just to try to capitalize on a lot of the fear in the market. But that one didn't work. So I cut the loss, like I said, around 4% and moved on to the next one. So now we can go up to Fiserv. All right, so here's Fiserv. This one also had a pretty big sell-off from its high. Let's see, it was off, just around 9%. you can kind of see a common theme. All these stocks, they really just, the market itself had a pretty big pullback. So that's when I decided to buy into pretty much everything that I've just showed you. But this one was actually kind of more for me a play on financials starting to report earnings. So earnings season is currently going on right now, and financials were really the first companies to kick that off. So we're going to have some of the big banks, like credit card companies and stuff like that. So I thought that would act as a catalyst for some of these good financial companies. So I decided to here, and then a couple days later, I sold it. It had a nice little pop, so a little 2% gain. And I really would have held on to this one, but it just wasn't doing that much. It was kind of just consolidating and only moving, you know, 1-2% every couple days. So I decided to just let this one go. I took the gain, moved on to the next one, something that I could hopefully try to get some more movement out of. I didn't really get as big as a jump as I thought I would with earnings. So I just decided to book that one, and I moved those over to Spirit. All right, so here's Spirit, and this is probably one of my favorite trades that I made. I actually have in my top five stocks to buy for January, one of the stocks was Spirit Airlines. And I really like this stock just because of all the pent-up demand that I think there is in the travel and just leisure industry itself. So same thing, I was kind of just looking for a pullback here. It's really been in a nice uptrend actually for the past like 6 months. I can go over. Yeah, so here's the 180-day chart. So this one didn't really have a big correction like the other four or five stocks that I just showed you did. But after hitting a high here, it had a pretty good pullback. So I bought in on this area right here, held it for a few days, and then it had a nice jump upwards of, I think it was like an 8% gain. So I sold it at that point. I'll probably look to actually buy into this one again, but it's kind of just been trading around the same level here for a couple days. So if we can see a little break below and kind of just keep this upward trend going, I'll definitely buy into this one again, as I think it has a lot of room moving forward. And I think it'll definitely move up to at least some new 6 month highs. I don't know if it's going to get all the way back to its all time high as where it was before the initial sell off in March. But I definitely like this one. I think it has a lot of room to go. So I'll be looking to kind of trade around it pretty actively. And airline stocks like this can have pretty aggressive intraday price swings. So the next time I enter this position, I'll probably look to hold it for a little bit longer, maybe like a couple weeks, even up to a month, just to try to catch a new all-time high. But yeah, that's kind of my thought process there. I was really just looking to hold on to this one for the longer term, but it had a pretty good rip in a couple days. So if I have an 8%, you know, gain on any position where the market has been, you know, going up for a few days and looks like it could be due for a correction, I'll likely book those gains and kind of move on to the next one. But yeah, there's a breakdown of all of those stocks that I bought and sold over the past 3 weeks or so. So I'll definitely do another one of these videos probably within the next month or so, maybe a month and a half, to give you guys an update on the next wave of stocks that I decided to buy. But if you guys like this video, make sure to leave a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.